So hello everybody and welcome to the final session of day six of our program. And welcome to the 2021 Global Animal Disaster Management Conference. I'm Mel Taylor, one of the organizing committee. Our next session is entitled Chemical, Biological, Radiological Risks for Dogs Involved in Search and Rescue Operations. And this is gonna be presented by Associate Professor Seville Tinguez, we're very happy to have her with us. And if you're interested to learn more about her or about her presentation, you can find her abstract and bio in our speakers section on the website. Before we start, I'm going to give a few housekeeping points. So the Zoom chat feature will be disabled for this meeting. If you have any questions, please type them in the Q&A section and we'll ask these at the end. We encourage you to use the hashtag GADMConf for Twitter and any social media. And when you close this presentation down at the end, you will have a short evaluation and we'd really appreciate it if you could fill that in for us. Just as a reminder, we are recording this session. So we will also be editing the videos and making them, releasing them all together at the GADMAC Awards in July. So without further delay, I would like to introduce Seville Tinguez to give her presentation on CBR risks for search and rescue operations. Thank you, Seville. Over to you.
Okay, thank you. Hello, everybody. Hello, my animal friends, science friends, love and critics from Turkey. Before starting my presentation, I would like to express my gratitude. Okay, start my video. Okay, love and gratitude from Turkey. Before starting my presentation, I would like to express my gratitude to individuals who contribute to the World Animal Disaster Management Conference and Platinum sponsor to giving us to this opportunity. I am Assistant Professor Seville Cengiz from Gümüşhane University, and these are my students and my assistants. Which we study together, Hasan Yücel and Orhan Veli Kartal. Today, I would like to give you information about hazards and risk of CBRN events for dogs involved in search and rescue operations. Before starting this presentation, I would like to start with human beings because everything starts with us. As you know, we people born and developed and then age and died. In this process, as we know, as we born, we can easily smell and feel and extra sense. We all the process. Our ears is here. The lowest and lowest and highest frequency range for human is 20 hertz and 20 kilohertz. This is low frequency age process, as you know. And also we see through the eyes, we can easily see for healthy people I talk about. Each of us expect at least 24/20, but admitted, no. Only little we can see. There are opportunity five. We have lots of olfactory receptors in human nose, and we can feel with skins. We can taste easily. But sometimes we think everybody, every word we owns this, owns us. We think we are the best of the worst, best of the best in the world. But no. We live our lives and then someday, suddenly, our worlds collapse. Because why? Because accidentally or deliberately or after a natural disaster happens, our worlds is collapse. And yeah, we can see. Yeah, we can smell. Yeah, we can feel. We can easily do them. But now, no. Because our world become dark and our ears do not hear because of the noise, because of the dust, Our nose does not smell and no taste. No think about this. No feel, more fear, I think. And then problems have just begun because disaster come. Like earthquake or flood or fire like this. Besides physical agents, we have also chemical, biological, radiological agents are released in the environment. And we are fear. You can think about, no, it couldn't possibility. There is no possibility like this. But if you look at this map, you can see lots of problems, lots of disasters in began and in occur every time, every minute. CBRN, which means that chemical, biological, radiological, and nuclear. It occur accidentally like fire, the explosion of the factory warehouse, you can see the pictures, or a vehicle carrying a chemical agent like train and tanker explosion. It can be. This is an accident. Or an oil refinery exploding after a natural disaster. I can easily give you an example, like in 1999 in Istanbul earthquake, we have Tüpraş oil refinery exploding. It occur 10 days and then lots of problems occur, chemical problems and other problems. These are accidents, as we say. Such exams are a few of the reasons that can be turned into chemical disaster. As you know, disaster handling by yourself. You cannot handle. You cannot any ability to handle them. Okay? As you say, these are the disasters. Or you can see also a chemical disaster like this, narcotic drugs. The problem of the wars are also a chemical disaster and also you cannot handle by yourselves, as you know. Biological, CBRN, chemical and biological, like this. These are biohazards constitute an important source of risk that can result in disasters or energy means. It is organic origin and includes danger to pathological biological organisms. Toxic substance or vector-borne disaster. We can be easily give an example like COVID in today's, you know. It is accident, I have some doubts, I think you do. You can see, we can easily give a pandemics for, give example for disasters. Like in 49 to others, you can say 13th to 14th centuries, lots of people die from Weba pandemics or cholera pandemics or like today's COVID. And RM, which is radiological and nuclear disaster. I cannot compare them, I cannot distance them because they are comes together with, okay. You can see they can be accidentally, yeah. COVID-19, you can be said. By I said, I explained then other dams. Or after natural accident, yeah, like Fukushima, you know, disaster shape. And then these times, a animal, a dog comes to help us. Yeah, only help, only a dog. We see, maybe we fear, maybe we love, only pet, no. These dogs comes with search teams, with together. You know, in the earthquake place and in the other place, we are very desperate. And we are very hopeless and we need help. Then the animals comes with the people. But are they super? No, no. Because this is international congress, I don't want to say this yes to search mode. No, dogs help us in many areas of life. Although search and rescue come when it comes to helping community. As we know, they are come with search and rescue. We all only remember this. We only said that, yeah, dogs come with rescue and search. No. The use of search, as we look at the history, the use of search rescue dogs were first recorded in 18. But some reports say that more fast and more early than this, this level. But as we look at the records, some stories arrow dogs during World War One and Two. Look at the picture. You can see them. They are from World War One and Two, and now also they can use for searching people living or non-living corpse like this, or for drugs, for mines, for explosives, and like everywhere. They are everywhere. You can see. They can use only after 2 and 3 months year. They give very very difficult trainings with their certificate trainings, and they usually repeat them, and then they go and they give very hard to people. You can see for. You can see help for hunting, forensic case, search and rescue, first of all. But also you can see it 11 September World Trade Center attacks, terrorist attacks. It is deliberately, I say it, disasters come with accidental deliberately and after natural disasters. This is very deliberately terrorism. It is also occur. And the animals comes from here, and then you can see the picture from them, from here. And then not only search and rescue, they also use some health problems. In this essay, we use some articles about this. Dogs help people in early diagnosis of bisphenophilus the bread and sweet of the patients for lung, colon, rectum, and bladder cancer. And also, they can use for determining low blood temperature, and used also pregnancy. And they also help people who are disabled is cause of spinal cord disorders, such as multiple sclerosis, Parkinson, and Alzheimer's, as you can see. They also used. And also, some of the new articles, you can see this today's Detective Corona today. A German veterinary clinic has training sniffer dogs for COVID-19 with 1994 occurrence, only smell. The dogs are conditions scanned of the corneas, sweet or others that comes from cells in infected people. These are cause of sniffer dogs to also use in everyday life, such as detected in virus, other than corona, attendance contacts, concerts. In concert, they're also used for the crowded people. Sniffer dogs can use in at airports in Finland and Chile to help determine the virus among the flyers. Okay, so how do dogs achieve this? Sensory organs in dogs, yeah, they have same, but more stronger than us. For usual function in the eye, start with the age of 6 weeks. As you know, we healthy people can easily born and see. But you can see if you have any pet or you can see, they can see after 6 weeks. Eyes are located in the front and both sides of the head, which provides dogs the wider vision angle than humans. Can see in the wide part of vision, even in the very little light. Fine details in the weaker than humans, they can only detect black and white and green tones in the little light. The colonic. Smell plays a very major role in many behaviors. The sensitivity of the sense of smell varies according to dog breeds. They are approximately 5 million. You only 2,000, I'm sorry, or 20,000 like this. Some of the antiquers, they say it different level. But the dogs are approximately 5 million of them receptors in the human bones. The German Shepherd dogs have 220 million scent receptors in its nose. Dogs use their sense sight to locate hidden objects during training. More sense of the smells. Besides the surface of the sophomore, the epithelial layers in the basal cavity, in humans, only 18 and 150 centimeter square. In dogs, the sophomore center in the brain approximately more in dogs and than in humans. If the length of the nose, dark pink and wetness are added to this, dogs are superior than humans. Except dogs are 100 or 1,000 times more capable than detecting scientific and predefined of smells. From the detection of the harmful insects, implants to fine air detection, the ability of the discriminate and the monitor scant is used approximately 30 areas. Dogs trained on certain subjects such as presence of drugs, narcotic drugs, explosives and mines and other illness from human scent. Smells, as I said, very measurable role. Used to determine the paralysis events seen in some diseases. Hypochemical, hypoglycemic attacks in diabetic patients. Attacks detect change in the density of some chemical substance with the super sense of the smell before attacks seem in magnitude tumor. Melanoma and the others, and epilepsy. And I also read an article, dogs can easily distinguish family members, siblings, and even identical twins by scent. I'm very shocked after reading this. Can detect even very small concentration of chemicals, concentration far below those that the human nose can detect. Hearing. Not so important like in smell, but it is also important. Well developed and can hear more distance and higher frequency sounds than human. As you know, in disaster areas, these people can see or can distinguish any other noise from outside, but they can easily distinguish them. The highest hearing capacity in humans decreased only 30,000 fear in seconds in childhood, but it decrease in old age. In dogs, this is more than human, as you can see. Use of disabilities while capturing prey that makes high frequency sounds. The ear structure in dogs suitable for hearing sounds coming from long distance, approximately 4 times more than humans. Taste also important like smells. Dogs sense taste from food occurs by smelling and tasting like humans. Dogs have fewer taste responses in the home mode than humans. They are 9,000 taste buds in the throat in humans and only 1,700 in dogs. Two types of receptors in taste buds. These are sugars and amino acid receptors. These are used for some detect molecules in fruits and some vegetables. Okay, it can be used for. Be used for meat and meat products deficiencies. Touch, yeah, it's also important. Since dogs, for their education is important because as we know, dogs educated with very high level of education, but it is increased with touching. Since dogs are social animals, species, they communicate with each others and with people by their sense of touch. High stroking and touching cause a decrease in the dog's heart rate and pressure, but stimulates the nervous system, as well as knowing, loving and talking dogs cause slowing of heartbeat and decrease in blood pressure in humans. This is also used for high tension pupils. By adapted at a dog, it also decrease in blood pressure in humans, that also determined in some essays. Dogs can capable of discovering and learning in environment with touch. Touch sensitive noise covering long hairs provide information to dogs about his environment. What are the potential CBRN risks and hazards in research and rescue dogs in SRAs, SER operations? Before coming to this, rescue and search teams, as you see, together with humans and one or two dogs. During a normal CBRN events, people in groups, they working with teams. They arrive at the scene wearing their personal protective clothes, some special clothes, and maybe only a little clothes, insulation aprons, goggles, face protection, medical masks, etc., or the others, ABC types clothes. They try to prevent secondary disasters by decontaminating themselves and environment with various methods in people. Maybe they can use some drugs such as atropine, strychnine, etc. For become and before and after the event they used, because they want to protect us. They want to protect them. But things change when it comes to dogs. Okay. They also want to protect, okay, protect. But they are also member of these teams. But think about it. The quickest way to find people lost and buried at the scene is work with dogs, okay. But they only work alone, Trained dogs are effective in harsh weather conditions. Search and rescue dogs are training to find living and non-living pupils. Okay, they go there, but need to alone. Why? Because it's dangerous. Because very narrow place, and but no clothes, no such a protective things, no decontamination. They go there. Okay, some of the pictures that I saw, look at this. The dog groomer cannot enter the disastrous cases for safety reasons, must only move along design space. We can see. Work without any protective equipment in educated disaster areas. And as you can see, this is the picture of World War I. This is the picture of World War II. As you can see, they wear a mask. Dog, and as you can see like this, and if you look at this, they also use a socks, paw socks. I'm sorry, I couldn't see it like this. You cannot distinguish maybe. During operation, standard policies and protocols require dogs to be video equipment that could socks in the prince. This is the standard. And I look at this picture, and I want to know is there enough or not, but no. Search dogs typically not wear any personal protective equipment because these equipments various rush during search operations. There is needed any methods for personal protective equipment does not interfere their ability to smell and hear or work. As you can easily see, they cannot easily smell, they cannot easily hear, and they cannot easily work ability, efficiency. And they used booze. Yeah, yes, they used because they were for warning sensation. But then their flexibility of the valves are very increased, very decreased. So they cannot use. Large-scale diseases cause the release and mix dozens of chemicals, potential contamination materials in disaster areas. The use of dogs in team participation studies, military enforcement, and public health roles push these animals at risk, like explosion of chemical, biological, and toxic agents. May be exposed to toxic substance through the skin. Terrorist attacks such as chemical warfare and destruction of the structure, they come to dogs. The percentage of the dust, harmful odors, and participate disaster matters are also pose harsh conditions for dogs. Most thermal explosion to chemical agents cause this direct injury or indirect to intact skin, while lipophilic agents can be absorbed through the skin, leading to systemic toxicity, as you can see this article. Searching, in particular, through piles of rubble requires caution, can be dangerous for the dogs. Dogs can be trained to trace location of dangerous and toxic odorous molecules, including explosive incendiary dogs and mice, etc. Six, search and rescue dogs frequently lick their nose while working. They have much higher potential for oral exposure to this toxic substance than their cravagers. One concurs about float waters for dogs during the deployment of search dogs at the screen. Following Hurricane Florence, contamination with natural gas, petroleum chemicals, radiations from healthcare sources, pesticides, fertilizers, coal ash, heavy metals, lead, and asbestos, as you can see this article. Dogs do not use breathing apparatus to perform their affirmative functions in the screen, which can leave them vulnerable to respiratory-related risk disasters. And also, they used, they determined, some of the article, they, new article, they determined the anatomical position of the dogs that are more likely contaminated during explosion to fluid dangers. You can see it is very decreased. You can see working dogs exposed to standing fluid hazards during the explosive activities were likely to vertically contaminated than abdominal locations. You can see. Environmental hazards have been measured concern for 8 workers after the attacks of World Trade Center on September 11. The building collapse and fire created hazardous environment for dogs, with emergency response teams exposing them to toxic chemicals. These are the chemicals that dogs explode, and they have lots of problems after that. May encourage potential toxic hazards, also biological hazards, cases of and chemical hazards, cases of like this also determined from other essay. The presentation of the biological hazards in deserts emergencies is also source of for dogs. Vector-borne disease, toxic substance, some or microorganisms, biohazards, it also poses a risk for animals. This is the World Convention. Therefore, the presentation of the biological substance at the screen where the research activity is created out may cause negative consequences for search and rescue dogs. Risk most at risk of explosive aerosol, biological and chemical contaminants include this common use in working disciplines, including labradors and sermon septimus is also used for. In addition to chemical constants, poisonous animals, plants are also risk. As you know, the search areas have also bees, snakes, spiders, and other animals poison the dogs and may cause may potentially cause death. Waterborne pathologies like salmonella and others cause disaster in dogs. contaminated in water, in the environment, and flooding and desalination. Besides, coronacases can pose at risk aquatic snakes like them. And also know, 42% of dogs under duty at the screen after hurricane frequency spent through the contamination in other essay shows this, and in other study shows this. As today's, as we know the COVID-19, as we know, look at this subject, I determined COVID is not new then. About 40 years they have COVID stories, but in these days we used for COVID detection, you know, and look at this article. COVID SARS-CoV-2 has been found into the process poorly in dogs, pigs, and chickens, allows the infection of the furs and cats. In other the article, the transmission models of are suitable for human transmission to cats. Although the routes of transmission are not fully determined, the virus mainly transmitted through respiratory droplets are spread during the coughing, sneezing, speaking, and breathing, which cause a highly efficient diarrhea and the other health problems. These are transmission formulas from head to mouth via eye conjunctivitis by touching the nose, hands, and contaminated with saliva and respiratory drops like human. Medical and industrial source are possible contaminated, are contain biologic materials, because there is a possibility of damage by fluid, mustard, and others. Dogs operate.
You're nearly at your time. You've nearly run out of time.
Okay. I about 5 more minutes, please. Can you give me?
Yes, okay.
Okay. These are the latest effects of the scientific syndromes, are dependent on explosion and main factors related to survivors. Okay. As you can see, these articles also shows that they also affected from radiological agents in search areas. Look at this, okay? And they have no any suitable clothes and others. And some shoes, I want to say last things. They some articles said that in the study conducted, the evaluated salivary cortisol levels are very increased in search and rescue dogs. As you know, cortisol levels is related to stress. Because of the stress, high level of stress, their cortical levels is also increased, and it causes early treatment and maybe could be good but less life. Suggestion for protection: SAR dogs, please, they must use a temporary material premise to absorption hazard of substance. It can be easily installed and removed, and is also not interfering their ability. And they efficiency moistened and cool dogs from exposure areas because of the burning dangerous place. Please, this is used for protective clothing, dogs' palms maybe, or sprays or drugs like this. Boots are available, please use. And then maybe they can easily trapped in that place. They must use a jacket, GPS tracking jackets for finding them. And some studies begun now. Robots for rescue, except for instead of dogs, they can be used easily, but not common. I'm sorry. Please save and like them and respect them like they are. Okay. Thank you for your patience. Is there any question to me?
Thank you so much, Professor Jinguez. That was a beautiful presentation. Lovely visual slides of the dogs, and I'm sure everybody watching has amazing admiration for our canine friends in these operations, because as you have outlined, they have such amazing abilities, far beyond our human abilities. But of course, there is such a welfare trade-off for them with these potential risks that you've outlined so well. At the moment, we don't have any questions from the delegates, but if anybody does have a question, yes, we do have a question. One moment. Okay, so this delegate is saying, congratulations on your talk. Is there any protective equipment you recommend specifically for working dogs?
No. I look at, I look at them. And one of the students is found this picture I show you. This is mask and the clothes. But they used that, but they said, no, there is no ability, because they couldn't smell, they couldn't hear, they couldn't easily action, but no, there is not any activity. They use dogs, but they don't think for protection them. So they said that we must use rubbers, but not very fastly.
No.
I look at also a mask and their efficiency in this COVID turn, but no, because their smells are very efficient. If you use mask, then no, yeah. They lost their ability. They ask why we used.
Yeah, it's so difficult, isn't it, to find a solution. And when contamination is involved as well, there is all the potential additional risk for the human to take that equipment off the dog and not become contaminated or spread contamination further. We have a second question here. I don't know if you can see it to read it as well, but again, thank you.
Where can we see?
If you look at the Q&A, so Veronica is asking about, she says, thank you for bringing the rescue dogs to our attention today. And again, we do acknowledge the wonderful job they do. Could you talk a bit more about disaster-related trauma in the dogs and how that is handled?
I look at the, some vegetarians journals, articles, and they used some trauma therapists, like touching, loving, and give love them and not talk. They only said you can retire 10 years and they celebrate retirement. They only there's no any traumatic psychological treatment. No, there's no. I look at them, but no.
Yeah,
I ask in Ankara, the dogs training centers, they go lots of events in Turkey. I talk them, they have their training place and their rehabilitation place, and they say there is no, in the world, there is no place for trauma treatment for dogs. No.
And you
see, we think on ourselves, ourselves. Yeah. We love them, but we think them on ourselves. They must help us, they must search us, for us, but no.
Yeah, the very selfish, perhaps selfish
anthropomorphic. Yeah, very, very selfish. Mm-hmm. I
suspect the handlers, I mean, the dog handlers usually have a very close relationship with their animals and want to protect them as well. So I suspect Veronica's question. There is trauma for the handler who is upset about the dog being injured or harmed or overly tired. Okay, I think we've got our questions. Look, thank you so much for joining us. I don't know what time of day it is for you. It's late here in Sydney, where I am in Australia.
Half past 11 in here, EM.
In the morning, okay.
Good morning, yeah.
Thank you again, and thank you to everyone who's attended this session, from wherever you are, or from whatever time zone you're in. So we have no further presentations during this day of the present of the conference program. Our next day begins in about 14 hours, And we have a presentation then from Gary Rogendui around veterinary behavioural health. So please come back and join us for day 7. And thank you once again for your presentation today, Professor. We really appreciated your time. Goodbye, everybody.